package in his upper body, but you got to take notice of Steiner's.
Hey, he's a power lifter. He's what, pressed, you heard somebody say 700 pounds?
Oh, my goodness. That'll wipe you out. About Rick Steiner. And David, you got to agree what Kevin says about Rick Steiner. Yes, he has all the potential in the world, and we have to agree with Kevin on both stands. And Rick Steiner is certainly a man to be.
Oh, here he goes. Look at him press.
I wonder if the Warlord's going to try that.
That is major league material right there.
You're with us at Senior Ringside. You got a shot right there of Kevin Sullivan. Kevin, Rick Steiner.
Let me talk to you about this Rick Steiner. You know, I've been around for a while, and I saw about 15 years ago a budding superstar. His name was Dusty Rhodes. This guy, Steiner, reminds me a lot of Dusty Rhodes. He's very intense, except for one thing. Rhodes always had a killer instinct, and Rhodes always was his own man. Rhodes, one thing you can say about Dusty Rhodes was he listened to himself. This Steiner has listened to the wrong people. He's listening to Eddie Gilbert. He's listening to guys like Akbar. He's listening to guys like James J. Dillon. This kid should be listening to himself. Now, this Steiner is a wrestling machine. He reminds me of a lot of another wrestling machine, Mike Rotunda. You know, Rotunda, the only thing lacking with Rotunda is the same thing lacking with Steiner. It's a parallel. They're not doing anything. What I'm saying is this, they should be picking out someone to go up and get a top match. This Steiner, now this is what I'm talking about. He's not paying attention. He's listening to other people. He should have his own strategy. He's a look. He's a wall of muscle.
Look at that body, though. It's an awesome figure in the ring, Kevin.
He's a wall of muscle right now, but he should be on top of this guy. I'll tell you what. If Rhodes had this guy, he wouldn't be giving me anything but a deep breath. You see, he's backing away. Now, Steiner should be on top of this man, controlling him, because he's a wrestling machine. All-American, the University of Michigan. Okay, he has made the transition into professional wrestling, but like again, I said, he's not listening to himself, he's listening to other people. Now, there's a wrestling move. Now we're talking, but he should be on the man. What is he smiling about? This isn't a funny business. This is professional wrestling. He should be start getting ready for something like the Buckout Stampede. You do that in the Buckout Stampede, you turn around and smile.
And your head.
You turn around and smile, you're not going to have any teeth to smile with. You see, now Steiner, see, he's doing this half-heartedly. He's ripping at the guy's eyes half-heartedly. I'm not trying to say that I'm the best and I'm the vicious and I'm the top. I'm not saying that. But I'm going to tell you what, if I was in there with Steiner, he wouldn't be smiling with me. Now, this kid is freaky, freaky strong. He's a power lifter, squats over 700 pounds. You can take a look at his legs. His shoulders look like a wall. But again, he's letting this guy back off. Again, another person I see do this. The Florida heavyweight champion, Mike Rotunda, does the same thing. He doesn't stand. Now, if I threw a guy on the floor, I'd be on top of him right there. He's giving the guy a chance to breathe. We're supposed to be prepared. I said, if he's listening to the wrong people, he's not on his game plan. This kid got more natural talent than anybody come along since probably Lex Luger.
Now,
devastating move. Now turn the guy over and beat him. What's he doing? You do that with someone like a Four Horsemen or a rope. Now,
the leg hook. He's gonna do it.
He could have done it a lot quicker, a lot smoother, and put it with a lot more punishment. This kid's got a long way to go. He's listening to the wrong type people. With a little guidance along the way, he could become a future champion.
Here again, Kevin, we're going to see the end of the match in slow motion again. Watch Steiner right here. Power move.
Power move, but the thing I don't like about this thing, he's smiling. This is not a funny business. This is serious. We got Bunkhouse Stampedes coming up with a lot of money involved. This kid better get his stuff together.
All right, the winner, Rick Steiner, and fans will be back. We'll have more.
This man really is. And Atlas also has world heavyweight title aspirations. Perez with a drive on Rick Hazard, who will really be in a tough spot this week. Last week he was annihilated by the Thing, and he'll have a tough, tough assignment here against the World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion in this non-title event. Want to welcome KRRT again in San Antonio, their second week. And also for the first time, KJMH in Burlington, Iowa, up in the Quad Cities area of the Heartland. There's Perez knocking Hazard back down. Lots of folks talking about the Thing, the Iron Sheik, gentleman Chris Adams, Mills Mascaris, all world-class wrestlers. Kevin Von Erich, of course, has been stripped of the World Heavyweight Wrestling title. We talked about that last week. As Perez is again the champion. Great penalty box main event this week for you. We've got a six-man bout from the Cotton Bowl and more. Hazard tries to work on Perez, but it's Perez in charge in the corner. Bruiser Brody wanting a shot versus the Iron Sheik. What a confrontation. Here's a pin. One, two, and three. Just like that, Al Perez has won. Gary Hart moves up quickly to congratulate him as we go to the ring and Ralph Pulley.
Winner of the match, Al Perez.
Well, Kevin Von Erich's
the winner, Vince Apollo. 245 pounds, the Latin heartthrob, Al Perez.
And there's the introduction for the world champion himself.
One ball, 60-minute time limit, Bronco Lubitsch,
referee. Bronco Lubitsch will be on the floor. John Keaton will be in the ring. As we're ready to get started, that's John Roberts of Eagle 97 Radio with the introduction. Perez having words already with Kevin and the Von Erich family. Kevin going over things with Fritz and Kerry in the corner. As Ralph Foley makes the referee clarification, we're about ready to go on this exciting event. And we're underway. Al Perez versus Kevin Von Erich for the World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion on a beautiful October afternoon at the Cotton Bowl on the State Fairgrounds in Dallas, Texas. Crowd of about 10,000 fans seated on the floor of the stadium and on the west grandstand level. Ready to see if Kevin Von Erich can bring the world-class gold back to the Von Erich household. Perez in charge with the arm bar. Perez has been a very tough man to meet. Not only because of his ability in the ring, which I will elaborate on momentarily, but also because of the great persuasive and managerial talents and abilities of Gary Hart, who has gone to the world-class Board of Governors, persuaded them to make the world title available for Perez to go after. When Perez won it and then lost it, he was able to persuade the board to give it back due to circumstances. Gary's a very one-sided lobbyer as Kevin electrifies the crowd by throwing Perez across the ring, and he moves in now for more. There's an elbow down. Perez all the way across the ring. Flying snapmare, and Kevin is in charge. This World Heavyweight Wrestling title bout is part of a marvelous all-afternoon world-class Cotton Bowl extravaganza that this crowd is enjoying. Kevin wrapping the leg around the waist. Remember, Kevin is very adept not only with the iron claw, but with the legs as well. There's Kerry talking to Fritz. Now let's talk a moment about Al Perez's wrestling ability. He is an outstanding professional wrestler. He has put wrestling back into professional wrestling, if you know what I mean. A great hold and counter hold man, a craftsman in the ring. He combines youth and charisma and strength all in the same move. He is an outstanding champion. He's going to be tough to beat for Kevin Von Erich or for anybody else that may go for this goal. But Kevin is certainly worthy of the challenge. We know his career like we know our own. Perez with the forearms in the midsection of Kevin Von Erich along the backside ring rope. There's a forearm to the head. Perez throws him, comes back, wanted to throw him over. Kevin surprises him, takes him down, and Perez is in the rope, and John Keaton will call for this to be broken.
5 minutes, 5 minutes gone.
We pass the official 5-minute mark of the match as Perez bails out. Fritz having words with Gary Hart, and there's Brian Adias. Because of the interference by Brian Adias back on Labor Day, when it was announced that Brian would be out here, then it was announced that Terry would be here too, and with Hart here, then it was announced that Fritz would be here. Hopefully, the two sides will equalize each other. Perez really taking his time as Gary Hart, who never misses anything during a bout, has words for his world champion. Kevin Von Erich ready to move in and continue. Hearing comments from our director about this exciting bout as it progresses. Here's Kevin over the rope being choked by Perez. Here's Kevin thrown near side, comes back, surprises Al Perez, puts him in the leg scissor. Kevin Von Erich learned how to use the legs during his visits to Japan and the Orient several years ago, and he's using them to his advantage right now. Al Perez in deep, dark trouble. Shoulders are pinned. One, and that's all. Now we'll watch Kevin's shoulders back in. Great match. These two had a 25-minute match Labor Day of 87. Watch the shoulders again. It's two. With the same kind of excitement. Now Perez trying to pin Kevin back here. Watch the shoulders. And down goes Perez. Kevin now rolling him around, maintaining the leg scissors around the torso of Al Perez. Watch shoulders again. One, two, and that's all. Kevin Von Erich maintaining the leg scissors in a miraculous fashion, now tries to pin Perez and use the iron claw. Perez must save himself from defeat and save himself from the paralyzing iron claw at the same time. This crowd of 10,000 fans urging Kevin on, but Perez is able to break the hold. Here's Perez with a kick. Perez with Kevin in the rope is going to kick him all the way out of the ring and carries around to help out his brother. Here comes Perez outside the ring. Remember, in world class, when a champion gets disqualified, he loses the belt, but Perez throws him back in before that can happen. Perez with Kevin closing. Here we go, collision course. Shoulder by the Latin heartthrob, and he's rolling now. Perez in charge with an knee, but Kevin out of the way to try to grab the momentum back. Great match here with the Cotton Bowl for the World Heavyweight title. Over along the ropes, more choking as Fritz looks on with concern. Perez now knocked out of the corner. Here's Gary Hart up hollering about Fritz and Kerry over on the side of the ring. Kevin high on the turnbuckle. Here comes Fritz after Gary Hart, who grabs a chair for his own protection and swinging it. Kevin comes from the turnbuckle, pins Perez, but he has a foot over the rope. In the meantime, Fritz is trying to physically put Gary in his chair and tell him to stay put. Kerry keeping Brian Adias out of that so that Fritz is able to put Gary where he belongs. Wow, so much to keep up with here in one match. We have three confrontating pairs. In the ring, Kevin and Perez still at it. Bronco Livid trying to keep Kerry and Brian apart. Fritz is trying to keep Gary in his chair. Perez with Kevin in the ring. Head in the turnbuckle. Perez getting rough in the corner, and Kevin follows suit. Kevin out of the way as Perez charges. It's still anybody's bout. Now comes Kevin with a tremendous elbow from the turnbuckle. Gary Hart beginning to get more and more concerned as Perez has more and more trouble with Kevin Von Erich. Perez is thrown in the other corner, comes back. Kevin throws and through the air over the shoulder. Kevin now to the midsection, to the face, and Perez ducks, but I think he helped Kevin go over that rope. I'm not sure if Kevin's momentum would have taken him over. Perez may have helped out. That is a close call for the referee to make. Very close, too close in my opinion. Kevin fighting back on the floor now that Perez has followed him out there. Kevin with a big run. Down goes Bronco Lubitsch, or rather John Keaton, and Bronco around to help out John Keaton as Kevin and Perez get back in the ring. Bronco may have to get in the ring if Keaton is unable to continue. Kevin turns Perez over the slam, wants to use the iron claw. And Perez tries to get loose. I believe Kevin has it in place. Yes, he does, on the forehead. Gary Hart on his feet as this crowd looks on with excitement. Gary reaches around and hits Kevin to break the claw. Fritz and Gary are into it. Brian tries to interfere, and Carey's there to stop that. Carey turns with a discus punch. Down goes Brian. Perez grabs Fritz, and Carey knocks Perez back in. Carey nails Perez to knock him off of Fritz. Kevin, in the meantime, is ready with a tremendous body press from the turnbuckle. Referee Bronco Lubitsch in the ring to count 1, 2, 3. Kevin Von Erich has become the world heavyweight wrestling champion despite the interference by everybody. Here's Carey in the ring. Gary Hart in the ring in a state of disbelief and astonishment.
75 pounds, Dave Barbie. And his opponent from Hawaii.
The steamer getting set to lock up with a very, very powerful young man announced earlier on. Dave Barbie outweighing the steamer by a few pounds.
Both wrestlers look to be in excellent shape, Vince McMahon.
Indeed there are, and right away Barbie trying to exert, yes and does, display a bit of superior strength, at least in that particular lockup. Taking nothing away from the strength on the part of Ricky Steamboat. Barbie trying to usher Steamboat into the corner and is successful indeed. And whoa, look out for the left hand. Look at that. Nice maneuver by the steamer. Arm drag takedown, and Barbie right away is in a little bit of trouble.
He's definitely in a little bit of trouble. Ricky Steamboat's not going to get caught off guard that early in the match, Vince McMahon. I do not believe so.
Steamer with somewhat of a wrist lock. Working on Barbie. And Steamer now applying a bit more pressure as Barbie gets back to his feet. Barbie very, very strong. That's his greatest asset. Barbie trying to set up the steamer. Whips him to the ropes off now. Nice shoulder block by the steamer, and Barbie goes nowhere. To the ropes again. Oh, yes. Barbie caught him with a body slam. Drops the elbow, but misses.
Ricky Steamboat's just too quick to fall for that, and with an arm drag takes Barbie back down, Vince McMahon.
Thus far, the steamer pretty much keeping Dave Barbie at bay. Barbie, very, very powerful young man. Lacks some in terms of experience, but is gaining it every single day.
Well, my opinion, Barbie's going to have to rough Ricky Steamboat up. He's not going to go hold for hold.
Dave Barbie at bay. Barbie, very, very powerful young man. Lacks some in terms of experience, but is gaining it every single day.
Well, my opinion, Barbie's going to have to rough Ricky Steamboat up. He's not going to go hold for hold with Rick Steamboat. He's going to have to go to rough tactics if he has any chance of winning this match.
Positive crowd looking on as Barbie now starts all over again in the standing position with Ricky Steamboat. Dimmer takes him over. Working on the left arm of Dave Barbie. Steps over now, a little more damage done, and over goes Barbie. Barbie is not moving. Hardly at all. He really doesn't show. They're very, very aware of your tactics, Mr. Ventura. In as well as out of the ring. Barbie now with a series of knee lifts, a right hand that caught him in the chops, and another one. Barbie with Ricky Steamboat gets him out, now whips him to the buckle. Barbie coming in after him, but no. Steamer with a heel of the boot on the top of the head. And Ricky Steamboat is in control, waiting for him cat-like. Oh, my. Forearm across the head, and the Steamer definitely in control now.
Well, Ricky Steamboat's looking real, real good here, Vince McMahon. Top condition, his moves are excellent.
Collision and a double chop to the throat area. Ricky Steamboat quickly out on the outside on the apron. Going up to the top rope now. Barbie getting up. Ricky Steamboat leaping with a flying body press. Steamer driving one home to the face. Hooks the leg, gets him up. We have two and three. Ricky Steamboat, a sensational athlete, and as you view this matchup, Mr. Ventura, I'm sure we'd like to pick your brain as to the...
Those quick moves and tremendous conditioning that he has. It makes him and his partner, Bobby Fulton, so, so very exciting. The fantastic Tommy Rogers, right there. He's got the arm barred. He's got Jack Vitry in trouble. Here. Trying to get his breath. He hasn't had a chance to do much. He's wrapped up with that left arm. You know, we mention every time that world-class championship wrestling is seen around the world, and that is true. And world-class championship wrestling, the competitors, the exciting men who make it go, will be in the Mideast. In the Middle East, in the first week in August. That's Tommy Rogers. He's exciting. He's fantastic. And his partner, Bobby Fulton, ready to give him a helping hand. Off the ropes. On top. Jack Vitry takes over for Vitry. Kaniski with Rogers going to do a bit of garrote on the rope. And Kaniski now trying to overcome some of that fire and enthusiasm and speed and ability of the fantastic Eddie Clothesline to Kaniski. Is not in top for a long time. That's just a count of one. And Kaniski moving in. Gonna try a neckbreaker. And he rips Tommy Rogers. Kaniski with an elbow drop across the chest. That's a count of two, but Rogers somehow fights out. Looks like he wouldn't have anything left after all that. But he is a fantastic. Here's an abdominal stretch. A sinister hold, a dangerous one. Vitry helping Kaniski put some more pressure on. Vitry pulling again, putting more pressure on, putting more pressure on Rogers. And now Rick Hazard has checked it out and puts a count on. Well, Vitry and Kaniski have teamed up into a pretty healthy duo. A flying elbow into the neck of Tommy Rogers. Vitry flies, but Rogers survives. A smash to the midsection. A kick by Rogers. He fights back. Oh, what endurance. A reverse donkey kick. And Rogers wants to go to the other corner. He's got to find his way over there. He falls. Gonna make it. Not quite. Not quite. Vitry pulls him back. Tommy trying again. They missed him. Oh, Tommy Rogers is forced to stay in the ring. There's an uppercut kick. Kaniski helping out a little bit. And Kaniski doesn't help Rogers, does help his partner Jack Vitry. Tommy moves. Here comes Bobby Fulton.